Hi, my name is Patrick Gertse, and today I'm going to show you how to model this bevel support gear. This is a video that I've recently uploaded and I didn't get a chance to get to it, so today I'm going to show you how to model it. This is the one that I finished in Blender, and this is the image that I've downloaded from the internet. I've already uploaded this picture into Blender, and I've already set the settings to millimeters and centimeters. Okay, let's start modeling. First, I'm going to go into the top view, press 7 and 5 to go into the top orthographic view, press W, merge to center. I'm going to extrude that on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. Since the radius is 25 millimeters, I'm going to extrude it another 10 millimeters on the y axis. I'm going to extrude it another 25 millimeters. So if you add this all up, it will be 60 millimeters. Since I'm going to work on this one half of this model, I'm going to cut that in half. If I should cut this in half, the distance from there, from the center point to there, will actually be 35. So I'm going to extrude that on the x-axis, 35 millimeters. Gonna extrude it on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. I'm gonna extrude it on the x-axis, 40 millimeters. Gonna extrude it on the x-axis, on the y-axis, 10 millimeters. From there, I'm going to extrude it 30 millimeters in, since 40 minus 10 gives you 30. And I'm going to extrude this. If you take this 25 and that's 10, gives you 35 minus that 10 gives you 25. Or you can just use this opposite sides, this opposite angles. So I'm going to extrude this on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. And since the radius is 25, cursor to select it, I'm going to rotate it. Where's the rotate button? No, it's actually the spin button. I'm going to spin it 180 degrees. I'm going to make it, okay, leave it at 9. Come on, let me just make it 8. So that center, that vertex can be on the center line of this x-axis. Gonna extrude it y-axis, 25 millimeters, since that the radius is 25 millimeters. And you can see from here the radius is 25 millimeters and the distance from there is 35 millimeters plus the 10 is 45 millimeters. So you take that 45 millimeters minus 25, it gives you 20. And then I'm going to extrude this on the x-axis, 20 millimeters. Okay, now we've got the top, where we'd finish the top part. Okay, now we're going to model that round shapes. So as you can see, the radius is 3 millimeters. Extrude it on the y-axis, 3 millimeters. And extrude it on the x-axis, 3 millimeters. Cursor selected. I'm going to click the spin button, and I'm going to make this 90 degrees. Gonna make this 6. actually 3, 4. Okay, I'm going to make it 4. I'm going to give it 4 steps. The same here. I'm going to extrude this on the x axis, 6 millimeters. I'm going to extrude it on the y axis, 6 millimeters. I'm going to make that the cursor, the center point. I'm going to spin minus 90. I'm going to leave it at 4. This one I'm going to extrude on the x axis 12 millimeters. I'm going to extrude on the y axis 12 millimeters. I'm going to make that the center cursor. I'm going to click spin. That's more like it. The radius there is 3. I'm going to extrude it on the x axis 3 millimeters. Extrude on the y axis 3 millimeters minus. I'm make that the center cursor, the center point. I'm going to click on spin. And that also going to be 4 steps. Okay, now I'm going to delete this vertices. I'm going to join that to that. That's more like it. Just like delete that vertex as well. And join these two. Okay, now we've got that weird finished modeling the top part. And delete that vertex as well. We're not going to need that anymore. Okay, that's more like it. Let me just go to I haven't been using Blender for a while, so I'm getting mixed up with these buttons. Edit mode. I'm gonna extrude that on the z-axis 25 millimeters up. That is 25 millimeters high. And I'm gonna select only these vertices, and I'm gonna extrude that. It's 38 minus 25. Extrude that 13 millimeters up. Extrude on Z axis 13 millimeters up. That is for that part there. For that part right there. Okay. I'm going to add select. Since we've got 4 here, I'm going to join these 4. And these 4. Control R, select cursor to select it. Can select that line there as well. Then I'm going to press what's that button now? Is it SY 0? Yep. Selected, it's S, it's x and 0. I'm going to join these two. Join these two. Add another S loop there. Cursor to select it. Select that one. And press S, Y, 0. Now just undo that. Cursor to select it. S, Y. S, Y, 0. That's more like it. Now I join these two. I can also join the bottom lines, but I'm not going to worry about that now. So it's 2, 2. So I'm just going to subdivide this in 2. Subdivide that as 2. Gonna fold that. Okay, that's more like it. Now we need to do the same on this side here. Go to the top view, vertex mode. I can join that, that. I'm gonna have to do something here. Switch to edge mode. Cursor to select it. Going to select this one as well. Going to press S, X, and 0. Then I'm going to join these two. To add another edge loop. Select that edge. Cursor to select it. Going to press S, X, and 0. Can join these two as well. Add another edge loop here. I'm going to select that vertex and that edge. I'm going to select Shift and S. I'm going to do the same here on the side. I'm going to join these two. Add another edge loop. Now this happens if you haven't been using Blender for a while, then you tend to forget which buttons to press. Control S, cursor to select it. Press S, Y, 0. I'm going to join these two as well. Okay, now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, let me just add another edge loop there. Select this one, cursor to select it, S, X, 0. Going to fold that. Then I'm going to divide this in 2. Fold that. Going to divide this in 3. Am I doing the right thing here now? Let's check her. Switch over to vertex mode. Okay. just add the edge loop here. Select this line here. Oh, this cursor selected. Press this. Press S, Y, and 0. Okay, that's not going to work. Undo. Going to split that into three parts. One, two, three. That's more like it. Now I'm finished with that part. I'm just going to do the top part now. Where this is. Connects through this. That is 25. And that is 38. The diameter, let me just check here. So it's 32 divided to 2, so it's 16 minus 25, it's 9. Gonna extrude that on the y-axis, 9 millimeters. Select the cursor vertices, the center vertices. And I'm also going to press spin here. I'm also going to give it 8. Make it 8 and make it minus 180. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now that I'm done with that, I'm just going to join that. That's more like it. Okay, now I can add a mirror. Okay, now I'm done with that part. Let me continue with the bottom part here. Actually, I forgot to make that 12 millimeter hole. But I see, extrude that on the z-axis, 12 millimeters down. I'm gonna extrude that on the x-axis, 12 millimeters minus. Okay, that's going to be the center vertice. Go to the front view. Just going to delete that face. Delete that face as well. Go to the front view. I'm going to extrude this. You see what is the radius here? It's 12, 12. So the radius is going to be 5 millimeters. I'm going to extrude that 5 millimeters. It's going to be my center cursor. I'm going to press spin and I'm going to make it 360 and let's give it 9 vertices. Make it 12 vertices. So I'm going to cut this in 3. In 2. And also 2. And also in 2. going to delete these edges, join that. Going to subdivide it to, okay, now I've got 3 times 4 is 12. Press F. Just what am I doing here? Face. Undo, undo, undo. Let's just delete this edge. Delete that edge as well. Undo W. Bridge two edges, that's more like it. And I'm going to select that thing that look like a horseshoe. Come select that vertices, shift D, Y. I'm just going to touch that point there. I can see it's joined. Come select the vertices, this inner vertices and that inner vertices. I'm going to press F. F, W, bridge loops. Okay, that's more like it. Now let's model the bottom part. Go to add select mode. Go and select the bottom vertices. And I'm going to extrude this. Let me just check here. The distance from there, right from the back till there to the front, is 88 millimeters. And the distance from there to there is 60 millimeters. So it's 88 minus 60 gives you 28, minus the 25 gives you 22. Gives you 3. So I'm gonna extrude that. I'm gonna extrude that vertice on the y axis 3 millimeters out. That is 90, since we cut it in half, it's going to be 45. I'm gonna extrude that on the x axis 45 millimeters. Okay. The distance from there to there is going to be 28 millimeters. Now press 25. Through the Y, 28 millimeters. Since 25 plus 3 gives you 28. The radius here is 12, so I'm going to extrude that on the Y axis. Let me deselect that. Extrude that on the y axis to 12 millimeters, and gonna extrude. Let me check. Extrude that also on the x axis 12 millimeters, and that is 12. And the radius here, let's check what's the radius here. This is also 12, so I'm gonna extrude it another 12 millimeters on the x-axis, extrude it on the y-axis another 12 millimeters. I'm gonna extrude it from here on the y-axis 12 millimeters. Make that my center point. Compress spin, make it 90, since that is a 90 degrees angle. Minus 90. I'm gonna give this, let me see, 4. Okay, I'll leave it at 4. This one I'm going to extrude it on the x-axis, 12 millimeters. I'm going to make that my center point. I'm going to click spin. 90 degrees. I'm going to leave it at 4. And that curve there is 6 degrees. The radius there is 6. So this is going to be from the bottom vertex. I'm going to extrude that on the x-axis, 6 millimeters in. I'm going to extrude it on the y-axis, 6 millimeters. I'm going to extrude it another 6 millimeters on the x-axis. I'm going to make that my center cursor. I'm going to select that, go to the top view, click spin, minus 90, yeah, that is at 6, and I'm going to join these two, deselect that vertex here. I'm going to deselect these vertices as well. Now I have to join this with this. Let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, let me just join it and see how far I get. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Change that to edge mode. It's better this way. I can see the vertices more clearly. Split this in. Split this in 3. And this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to split this in 5. Like it. Let's go to vertex mode. Let me see. So delete that vertex there. I'm gonna join these two. Gonna subdivide it 3 times. That's more like it. Now finish with that part. That is 10 millimeters down. So I'm going to select this. Yeah, these vertices, these like that, and that, and that. Extruded on the z-axis, 10 millimeters down. Gonna do the same here. Extruded on the z-axis, 10 millimeters down. And now let me see. From there till there is 66 millimeters. Switch over to vertice mode. Can select that center vertice, which is that one there. I'm going to extrude it on the z-axis, 66 millimeters down. That is 66 millimeters here. Okay, the radius is the diameter is 38 millimeters, so I'm going to extrude that the z-axis 19 millimeters, and that the diameter of that one is 20. I'm going to extrude that 10. Just check. Extrude that on the z-axis 10 millimeters. At the center point, click on that vertice, can click on spin 360, come make this 8 as well, select that vertice, click spin, that's more like it. Now I'm going to just delete that edge, delete this edge as well, and that one as well. Press W, bridge loops, select the vertices. Extrude it on the x-axis 3 millimeters. And this I'm going to extrude here. I should actually join this with that. F, and now I should take these two lines and I'm gonna extrude that on the x-axis 10 millimeters in. I'm just going to select, let's see, deselect that part. Extrude that on the z-axis 3 millimeters out. That's more like it. Now I have to join. Where's the picture now? The radius is from there to right down is 25 millimeters. So I'm going to the top. Let's check over here. Eighty-eight minus 28 gives you 60. So I must extrude it from there. Let's check over here. Beginning from this point here, got to extrude this y-axis 60 millimeters. Extrude it on y-axis 60 millimeters. Where is that? Go desktop view again, extrude y axis 60 millimeters. That's more like it. Gonna extrude this on the x axis 25 millimeters. Extrude on the x axis. No. Extrude on the z axis 25 millimeters down. I'm gonna make that my center cursor. And I'm gonna click that here. And I'm gonna click on spin. Make it 90 degrees. I don't know how much it is. Let me see how much. It doesn't give you an angle. They don't give you the angle of this side here. Let me just check here. It's 25. Let me spin it on a 90 degrees angle. Minus 90. And now I'm going to join that with that. Okay, it should be right. Let me just delete that vertex here. Join these two. F. Okay, now it seems to be right. I'm going to delete that vertex. Select that line. Just going to deselect this other side. I think I should leave this with C as well. And I should join this with that. F, let me just check again. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Extrude that on the x-axis 10 millimeters. I just have to join these. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's check here. I'll subdivide this, make it 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Subdivide this well. three times. Subdivide this twice. If I'm going to move that up, let me just check over here. To select it, select that vertice, extrude it, the Z axis 25 millimeters down, cursor to select it. I'm going to select these two lines, take that two lines, and now I'm going to rotate it. Click on the snap on tool, vertice, and rotate it. Let's see, looks right. Undo, rotate it. Click on that. Could just leave it at that. So I don't know if I have to move that in. So leave it at that. Gonna delete this line here. And I think I should move this up. Just delete that edge. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Subdivide it in 2. Okay, that's more like it. Click on faces. Click on Shift and D, duplicate. Click on that also, vertices. Gonna press G, X. Let's snap on there. Okay, I think that's more like it. You can fill this bottom part in yourself if you want, if you feel like it. Click on this, first click on this smooth, gonna click on add split, Okay, let's add the sub surf modify. Move that up. Move this add split. Where is it? Add split. Just delete that add split. Move that up. How can they delete the subsurf modify? Control N. Add the add split. I think I should have added more vertices here on this side. See how many vertices I put here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I should have at least put 16 here on this side. Let me just leave it like that. And that is how you model the bevel gear modifier. Thank you for watching. Bye. Hi, my name is Patrick Gertsen. And today I'm going to show you how to model the bevel support gear. This is a video that I've recently uploaded and I didn't get a chance to get to it, so today I'm going to show you how to model it. This is the one that I finished in Blender, and this is the image that I've downloaded from the internet. I've already uploaded this picture into Blender and I've already set the settings to millimeters and centimeters. Okay, let's start modeling. First, I'm going to go into the top view, press 7 and 5 to go into the top orthographic view. Press W, merge to center. I'm going to extrude that on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. Since the radius is 25 millimeters, I'm going to extrude it another 10 millimeters on the y axis. I'm going to extrude it another 25 millimeters. So if you add this all up, it will be 60 millimeters. Since I'm going to work on this one half of this model, I'm going to cut that in half. If I should cut this in half, the distance from there, from the center point to there, will actually be 35. So I'm going to extrude that on the x-axis, 35 millimeters. Gonna extrude it on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. I'm gonna extrude it on the x-axis, 40 millimeters. Gonna extrude it on the x-axis, on the y-axis, 10 millimeters. From there, I'm going to extrude it 30 millimeters in, since 40 minus 10 gives you 30. And I'm going to extrude this. If you take this 25 and that's 10, gives you 35 minus that 10 gives you 25. Or you can just use this opposite sides, this opposite angles. So I'm going to extrude this on the y-axis, 25 millimeters. And since the radius is 25, cursor to select it, I'm going to rotate it. Where is the rotate button? No, it's actually the spin button. I'm going to spin it 180 degrees. I'm going to make it, okay, leave it at 9. Come on, let me just make it 8. So that center, that vertex can be on the center line of this x-axis. Gonna extrude it, y-axis, 25 millimeters, since the radius is 25 millimeters. And you can see from here, the radius is 25 millimeters, and the distance from there is 35 millimeters plus the 10 is 45 millimeters. So you take that 45 millimeters minus 25, it gives you 20. And then I'm going to extrude this on the x-axis, 20 millimeters. Okay, now we've got the top, we finished the top part. Okay, now we're going to model that round shapes. So as you can see, the radius is 3 millimeters. Extrude it on the y-axis, 3 millimeters. Extrude it on the x-axis, 3 millimeters. Cursor selected. I'm going to click the spin button, and I'm going to make this 90 degrees. I'm going to make this 6. Let's see, 3, 4. Okay, I'm going to make it 4. I'm going to give it 4 steps. The same here. I'm going to extrude this on the x-axis, 6 millimeters. I'm going to extrude it on the y-axis, 6 millimeters. I'm going to make that the cursor the center point. I'm going to spin. Minus 90. I'm going to leave it at 4. This one I'm going to extrude on the x-axis, 12 millimeters. I'm going to extrude on the y-axis, 12 millimeters. I'm going to make that the center cursor. I'm going to click spin. That's more like it. The radius there is 3. I'm going to extrude it on the x-axis, 3 millimeters. Extrude on the y-axis, 3 millimeters minus. I'm make that the center cursor, the center point. I'm going to click on spin. And that also going to be 4 steps. Okay, now I'm going to delete this vertices. That okay, that's more like it. Delete that vertice as well and join these two. Now we've got that weird finished modeling the top part. I'm going to delete that vertice as well. We're not going to need that anymore. Okay, that's more like it. Let me just go to I haven't been using Blender for a while, so I'm getting mixed up with these buttons. Edit mode. I'm going to extrude that on the z-axis, 25 millimeters up. That is 25 millimeters high. And I'm going to select only these vertices. And I'm going to extrude that. It's 38 minus 25. Extrude that 13 millimeters up. to the Z axis, 30 millimeters up. That is for that part there. For that part right there. Okay. I'm going to add select. Since we've got four here, I'm going to join these four. Control R, select, cursor to select it, select that line there as well. Then I'm going to press, what's that button now? Is it SY0? Yep. Selected, it's X and 0. I'm going to join these two, add another S loop there. Cursor to select it, select that one, and to press SY0. Now just undo that. Cursor to select it. SY0, that's more like it. Now I join these two, or I can also join the bottom lines, but I'm not going to worry about that now. So it's two, so I'm just going to subdivide this in two. Subdivide that as two. Gonna fold that. Okay, that's more like it. Now we need to do the same on this side here. Go to the top view, vertex mode. Can join that. I'm gonna have to do something here. So switch to edge mode. Cursor to select it. Can select this one as well. Go to press S, X, and 0. Then I'm going to join these two. To add another edge loop, select that edge, cursor to select it, press S, X, and 0. Can join these two as well. Then add another edge loop here. Select that vertex and that edge. I'm going to select shift and S. I'm going to do the same here on the side. I'm going to join these two. Add another edge loop. Now this happens if you haven't been using Blender for a while, then you tend to forget which buttons to press. Control S, cursor selected, press S, Y, 0. I'm going to join these two as well. Okay, now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, let me just add another. Let's look there. Select this one. Cursor to selected. S, X, 0. Going to fold that. Then I'm going to divide this in two. Going to fold that. Going to divide this in three. Am I doing the right thing here now? Let's check her. Switch over to vertex mode. Okay. Just hit the edge loop here. Select this line here. Hold this cursor selected. Press this. Press S, Y, and 0. Okay, that's not going to work. Undo. Going to split that into three parts. One, two, three. That's more like it. Now I'm finished with that part. I'm just going to do the top part now. Where this is. Connects through this. That is 25. And that is 38. The diameter, let me just check here. So it's 32 divided to 2, so it's 16 minus 25, it's 9. Gonna extrude that on the y-axis, 9 millimeters. Select the cursor vertex, the center vertex. And I'm also going to press spin here. I'm also going to give it 8. Make it 8 and make it minus 180. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now that I'm done with that, I'm just going to join that. Press fold, that's more like it. Okay, now I can add a mirror. Okay, now that I'm done with that part. Let me continue with the bottom part here. Actually, I forgot to make that 12 millimeter hole. But I see, extrude that on the z-axis, 12 millimeters down. I'm gonna extrude that on the x-axis, 12 millimeters minus. Okay, that's going to be the center vertex. Go to the front view. Just going to delete that face. Delete that face as well. go to the front view. I'm going to extrude this. You see what is the radius here? It's 12, 12. So the radius is going to be 5 millimeters. I'm going to extrude that 5 millimeters. It's going to be my center cursor. I'm going to press spin, and I'm going to make it 360. And let's give it 9 vertices. Make it. So I'm going to cut this in 3. In 2. And also 2. And also in 2. Delete these edges, join that. I'm going to subdivide it to, okay, now I've got 3 times 4 is 12. Press F. Let's just delete this edge. Delete that edge as well. Undo W. Bridge 2 edges. That's more like it. And I'm going to select that thing that looks like a horseshoe. Come select that vertices, shift D, Y. I'm just going to touch that point there. I can see it's joined. Come select the vertices, this inner vertices and that inner vertices. And I'm going to press F, F, W, bridge loops. Like it. Now let's model the bottom part. Go to add select mode. Go and select the bottom vertice. And I'm going to extrude this. Let me just check here. The distance from there, right from the back till there to the front, is 88 millimeters, and distance from there to there is 60 millimeters. So it's 88 minus 60 gives you 28, minus the 25 gives you 20, gives you 3. So I'm gonna extrude that. Connects to that vertice on the y axis 3 millimeters out. That is 90, since we cut it in half, it's going to be 45. Connects to that on the x axis 45 millimeters. Okay, the distance from there to there is going to be 28 millimeters. Press 25. through the Y, 28 millimeters. Since 25 plus 3 gives you 28, the radius is 12, so I'm going to extrude that on the y-axis. Let me deselect that. I'm going to extrude that on the y-axis to 12 millimeters, and I'm going to extrude. Extrude that also on the x-axis 12 millimeters, and that is 12, and the radius here, let's check what's the radius here, this is also 12, so I'm going to extrude it another 12 millimeters on the x-axis, extrude it on the y-axis another 12 millimeters, extrude it from here on the y-axis 12 millimeters, gonna make that my center point, press spin, make it 90, since that is a 90 degrees angle, minus 90. I'm gonna give this, let me see, 4. Okay, leave it at 4. This one I'm gonna extrude it on the x-axis 12 millimeters. I'm gonna make that my center point. I'm gonna click spin 90 degrees. I'm gonna leave it at 4. And that curve there is 6 degrees. The radius there is 6. So this is going to be from the bottom vertex. Gonna extrude that on the x-axis 6 millimeters in. Gonna extrude it on the y-axis 6 millimeters. Extrude it another 6 millimeters on the x-axis. I'm going to make that my center cursor. I'm going to select that. Go to the top view. Click spin. Minus 90. Yeah, that is at 6. Now I'm going to join these two. I'm going to deselect that vertex. Deselect these vertices as well. Now I have to join this with this. Let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me just join it and see how far I get. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Change that to edge mode. It's better this way. I can see the vertices more clearly. Split this in. Split this in 3. this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to split this in 5. Okay, that's more like it. Let's go to vertices mode. Let me see. So delete that vertices there. I'm gonna join these two. Gonna subdivide it 3 times. That's more like it. Now finish with that part. That is 10 millimeters down, so I'm going to select this. These vertices, these like that, and that, and that. I'm going to extrude it on the Z axis 10 millimeters down. I'm going to do the same here, extrude it on the Z axis 10 millimeters down. Let me see, from there till there is 66 millimeters. Switch over to vertices mode. You can select that center vertices, which is that one there. I'm going to extrude it on the Z axis 66 millimeters down. That is 66 millimeters here. Okay, the radius is the diameter is 38 millimeters, so I'm going to extrude that the Z axis 19 millimeters, and that the diameter of that one is 20. I'm going to extrude that 10. Just check. Extrude that on the Z axis 10 millimeters. At the center point, click on that vertice, you can click on spin 360, come and make this 8 as well, select that vertice, click spin, that's more like it. Now I'm going to just delete that edge, delete this edge as well, and that one as well. Press W, bridge loops, select the vertices. Extrude it on the x-axis 3 millimeters. And this I'm going to extrude here. I should actually join this with that. F, and now I should take these two lines and I'm gonna extrude that on the on the x-axis 10 millimeters in. I'm just going to select, let's see, deselect that part. I'm going to extrude that on the z-axis 3 millimeters out. That's more like it. Now I have to join. Where's the picture now? The radius is from there to right down is 25 millimeters. So I'm going to the top. Let's check here. Eight minus 28 gives you 60. So I must extrude it from there. Let's check here. Beginning from this point here, got to extrude this. The y-axis 60 millimeters. Extrude it on the y-axis 60 mm. Where is that? Go to the top view again. Extrude y-axis 60 millimeters. That's more like it. Gonna extrude this. X-axis 25 millimeters. Extrude on x-axis. No. Extrude on the z-axis 25 millimeters down. I'm gonna make that my center cursor, and I'm gonna click that here, and I'm gonna click on spin, make it 90 degrees. I don't know how much it is. Let me see how much. It doesn't give you an angle. They don't give you the angle of this side here. Let me just check here. It's 25. Let me spin it on a 90 degrees angle. Minus 90. And now I'm going to join that with that. Okay, it should be right. Let me just delete that vertex here. Join these two. F. Now it seems to be right. I'm going to delete that vertice. I'm going to select that line. Just going to deselect this other side. I think I should leave this with C as well. And I should join this with that. F, let me just check again. I'm just gonna leave it at that. extrude it on the x-axis, 10 millimeters. I just have to join these. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's check here. Subdivide this, make it 3 times, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. Subdivide this well 3 times. Subdivide this twice. If I'm going to move that up, let me just check over here. To select it, select that vertice, extrude it, the Z axis 25 millimeters down, cursor to select it, I'm going to select these two lines, take that two lines, and now I'm going to rotate it. Click on the snap on tool, vertices, and rotate it. Let's see if it looks right. Undo, rotate it. Click on that. Just leave it at that. So I don't know if I have to move that in. So leave it at that. Gonna delete this line here. I think this would move this up. Just delete that edge. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Subdivide it in 2. bracket. Click on faces. I'm going to click on Shift and D duplicate. Click on it also, vertices. Gonna press G, X. Let's snap on there. Okay, I think that's more like it. You can fill this bottom part in yourself if you want, if you feel like it. Gonna click on this, first click on this smooth, gonna click on add split, okay, let's add the sub serve modify, move that up. Just deleted ad split. Move that up. Let's see. How could you delete the subset modify? Control N. I think I should have added more vertices here on this side. See how many vertices I put here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I should have at least put 16 here on this side. Let me just leave it like that. And that is how you model the Bevel Gear modifier. Thank you for watching. Bye.